just one thing that I want to say. Blessings that I cannot see.
Thank you.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. With a grateful heart, with a song of praise, with an outstretched arm,
I'm
I searched the earth for something that could satisfy, a piece for the hurt I had buried deep inside. Knees on the floor, I finally found everything I needed. You lifted my soul and opened up my eyes. And I never knew anything was forever till I found you, till I found you. I never dreamed anything could be better till I found you, till I found you. Chasing after what won't last. I'm done with building these castles that crumble like sand. Oh, knees on the floor, I finally found that everything I needed was always right in front of me. You gave me a name and you changed everything, yeah, yeah.
Good morning, church. We are so happy and blessed to still be able to gather as one through online services. I hope that you are doing well in your houses. Now, if you have your Bibles with you, kindly open it together with me on Malachi chapter 1, verses 6 to 7. In Malachi chapter 1, verse 6 to 7, it says that the Lord of heaven's armies says to the priest, "A son honors his father, and a servant respects his master. If I am a father and a master, where are the honor and respect I deserve? You have shown contempt for my name, but you ask, how have you ever shown contempt for your name? You have shown contempt by offering defiled sacrifices on my altar. Then you ask, how have you defiled the sacrifices? You defile them by saying, the altar of the Lord deserves no respect." Praise be to the word of God. Just a little bit background, church. Malachi must have been written after the temple had been rebuilt, since he referred to worship there. In this passage of scripture, in verses 6 to 7, God, through Malachi, was addressing the priests unto why they have shown the Lord a half-hearted service, honor, and respect. The priests have offered defiled sacrifices. The priest called God their master, who ruled over them, the Lord of Lords, the King of Kings. And yet their actions and doing were not honorable, and the priests did not show him the reverence that the Lord deserves. The priests were only trying to appease God, not please God. Appease, according to wikidiff.com, is to make quiet or to calm, or to reduce to a state of peace, or to dispel an anger or hatred, while please is to make someone happy and satisfied, or to give pleasure. And that is what God would have wanted, to be pleased and not appeased. They were only trying to reduce the anger of God, not totally pleasing Him. Church, we do all kinds of things for someone if he or she is special to you. You want him or her to be happy or satisfied by the things that you have done or given to him or her. That is what we call love. Fear, on the other side, is doing things for the sake of ourselves, not to get hurt. And that is what the priests have shown to God. They have feared God and not loved God because they were only afraid to get hurt. Church, we need to remind ourselves that one of the attributes of God is that our God is a compassionate and a loving God. God doesn't want us to be afraid of Him. Sacrifices and works done out of fear only means that we don't really know God. Church, I want you to realize that God loves us. He truly loves us. And He wants us to give Him the respect and love that He deserves. So church, our prayer this morning is that we will truly understand who God is in our lives. That God will take away our fear, and instead we will show Him the honor and respect and love towards Him. So church, let us worship our God. Let us stand before Him. Let us come before Him in reverence and in awe of His goodness. O God, Lord, truly, O God, You are the God who is so loving, who is so merciful, who is so gracious. And O God, Lord, You accept us, O God, Lord, despite of our sins, despite of our sa mga pagkulang diha kanimo, God. But You never failed us, O God. You have shown us the love, O God, Lord, that is undeserving. Oh, how wonderful, O God. Oh, how gracious and so loving You are. And, O God, Lord, nothing can stop us. Nothing, O God, Lord, and nothing will ever stop us from worshiping You, O God, Lord, Father. And, O God, Lord, as we sing this song, O God, lift it up to You, O God, Lord, with wholeheartedly, O God, Lord, with all of our praise and our worship, God, Lord, because You deserve it, O God, Lord, Father. Thank you. Cause he has saved us, called us blameless, guides us now and will sustain us. Oh, how wonderful the Father's love. Our lives with holiness. Your grace has colored all we see, and you have promised not to leave. You freely give your Spirit to us, so we can be sure we're sons of God and rest in the hope of what's to come. How wonderful Father's love, Father's love for us, that he would send his only son to come and rescue us. Cause he has saved us, called us blameless, guides us now and will sustain us. Oh, how wonderful the Father's love. Those sufferings within our lives, confident, we're heirs to Christ, and so we cry, Abba Father. The sufferings, we feel our lives, we're confident, we're heirs to Christ, and so we cry, Abba Father. How wonderful the Father's love for us, that he would send his only son to rescue us. How wonderful the Father's love for us, that he would send his only son to rescue us. How wonderful the Father's love for us, that he would send his only son to come and rescue us. Cause he has saved us, called us blameless, guides us now and will sustain us. Oh, how wonderful the Father's love. Oh, how wonderful is your love, God. God, Lord, search our hearts and our minds, God. Lord, you created us and you therefore know us, O God. Good Lord, let not our hearts be in control, but your will, O God. Lord, help us to know you more. Help us to know who you really are, O God, Lord, Father. God, Lord, lead us with your Holy Spirit, O God. Lord, take away, O God, Lord, any iniquities or sins that is keeping us from worshiping you, O God, Lord. Instead, O God, Lord, fill us, O God, with your Holy Spirit, so that we may gain the wisdom and knowledge, O God, Lord, so that we can come before you, O God, and to worship, O God, Lord, Father. And so, God, Lord, we will continue, God, Lord, to sing songs of praises to you, God. We adore you, God, Lord. We're in awe of you, God.
Grasp your infinite wisdom. Who can fathom the depths of your love? 'Cause you are beautiful beyond description. Majesty enthroned above.
Come on, church, let's sing.
And I stand, I stand. God, to whom all praise is due, I stand in awe of you.
Tackle your word, O God, Lord. Open our hearts and our minds, O God, Lord. And, O God, Lord, kung unsa man among makatunan karon, O God, Lord, amo lang mang iuli diha kanimo, O God, Lord. All the glory, O God, Lord. All the highest praises and thanks. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen.
Happy Lord's Day. And once again, welcome to Living Word South Morning Service. Praise God for another Sunday, and indeed, God is good. And for the last couple of Sundays, we continue our series of study in the book of James. And indeed, book of James is a wonderful book. And this is the last segment of book of James. So we'll be finishing James chapter 5 today. And if you have a Bible with you, can you please open your Bible in book of James chapter 5, verse 12 up to verse 20. And this is what the Bible declares. But above all, my brethren, do not swear, either by heaven or by earth or with any other oath. But your yes is to be yes and your no, no, so that you may not fall under judgment. Is anyone among you suffering? Then he must pray. Is anyone cheerful? He is to sing praises. Is anyone among you sick? Then he must call for the elders of the church, and they are to pray over him, anointing him with oil in the name of the Lord. And the prayer offered in faith will restore the one who is sick, and the Lord will raise him up. And if he has committed sins, they will be forgiven him. Therefore, confess your sins to one another and pray for one another so that you may be healed. The effective prayer of a righteous man can accomplish much. Elijah was a man with a nature like ours, and he prayed earnestly that it would not rain, and it did not rain on earth for 3 years and 6 months. Then he prayed again, and the sky poured rain, and the earth produced its fruit. My brethren, if any among you strays from the truth, and one turns him back, let him know that he who turns a sinner from the error of his way will save his soul from death and will cover a multitude of sin. Let us pray. Father, we thank you, God, for this Sunday, Lord. We thank you for the book of James, Lord, that we learn a lot. We learn a lot about faith. And Lord, we thank you that indeed, O God, this book, Lord, nga among natunan, it's a blessing to us, O God. Kani tabang yusab kami, Lord, nga kining among nakatunan ni mga bruha. We can use it, O God, to share to others, Lord, wherein more souls will come to the saving knowledge of our Lord Jesus Christ. And Father God, help us, O Lord, that kining tanan nga among nakatunan, not just, O Lord, nga para lang sa among kagalingon, but Lord, help us na mahimo sa kining panalangin. And Father, we give you thanks and praise in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Today our study book of James draws to a close. And indeed, what a powerful lesson we learn, not just theologically, but also on the practical aspect of what Christian faith is all about. And just to wrap up the whole chapters, in chapter 1, it says, consider it pure joy when you face trials. Why? Because they are tests sent by the Father to allow us to demonstrate our spiritual maturity. Now, in chapter 2, it says, don't show favoritism. Why? Because favoritism is showing what we call, we violate the royal law if we apply favoritism into our life. Now, in chapter 3, it says, guarding our speech is a key to avoiding a life of disobedience and yielding to the Spirit to control our tongue. And in chapter 4, James gives us a warning to the self-sufficient and a prideful Christian. And in chapter 5, James opened with a warning against the danger of pursuing riches. And now, he finishes with a series of exhortation on believers' spiritual roles. Now, I titled the sermon, Believers' Spiritual Roles. Now, we have to discuss 5 things about our roles while waiting for the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. Now, the first one is in verse 12. We need to be a man with word of honor. And the second one in verse 13 to verse 14. We need to be a man who care each other. And the third one is that we need to be a man of faith in verse 15 to verse 16. And the fourth one, we need to be a man of prayer in verse 17 to verse 18. And the last one, we need to be a man of encouragement in verse 19 to verse 20. Now, let's go to the first one. Now, it says in verse 12, but above all, my brethren, do not swear either by heaven or by earth or with any other oath, but your yes is to be yes, your no, no, so that you may not fall under judgment. Now, in the previous chapter, James already warned us about the tongue. If you recall James chapter 1, verse 19, it says, let every person be quick to hear, slow to speak, and what? Slow to anger. And in James chapter 1, verse 26, it says, if someone thinks he is righteous and does not bridle his tongue, but he deceives his heart, this person's religion is what? Is worthless. Now, listen to chapter 3 of book of James. It says that tongue is a small member, yet it boasts of great things, and not only that, tongue is a fire. Now, as believers, we must exercise caution with our speech. And James plainly says, just let your yes be yes, and let your no be no. What James says is that don't swear in the name of God. Remember, if you choose to make a vow by praying in God's name, the scripture says that God will bring penalty upon you for failing to keep that vow. How? Listen to book of Ecclesiastes chapter 5, verse 4 to verse 6. When you make a vow to God, do not be late in paying it, for he takes the delights in fools. Pay what you vow. It is better that you should not vow than that you should vow and not pay. Do not let your speech cause you to sin. And do not say in the presence of the messenger of God that it was a mistake. Why should God be angry on the account of your voice and destroy the work of your hands? And in the New Testament, our Lord Jesus Christ gave the same warning in the Sermon on the Mount in the book of Matthew chapter 5. Now, listen to book of Matthew chapter 5, verse 33 to verse 37. And this is what the Lord says. Again, you have heard that it was said to those of old, you shall not swear falsely, but shall perform your oath to the Lord. But I say to you, do not swear at all, neither by heaven, for it is God's throne, nor by the earth, for it is His footstool, nor by Jerusalem, for it is the city of the great King. Nor shall you swear by your head, because you cannot make one hair white or black. But listen to this. Let your yes be yes, and let your no, no. For whatever is more than this is from the evil. Meaning, be a person of your word. If you say yes, that means yes. If you say no, that means no. Why? Because there's a warning. Listen to the warning according to the Word of God. So that you may not fall under judgment. Now, the major problem was taking the name of God in vain. You recall in the Old Testament, in the book of Exodus chapter 20, verse 7, the Bible declares, thou shalt not take the name of God in vain. So, what we have to do? We need to keep very close watch over your speech. Why? One day, you and I, according to 2 Corinthians chapter 5 and book of Romans chapter 14, each believer will stand before the Holy God to give an account for how he delivered on the stewardship of his life. And Paul warns us that we need to speak in the truth with love, according to book of Ephesians chapter 4, verse 15. Now, let's go to the second one. Be a man who care each other. Verse 13 it says, is anyone among you suffering? Then he must pray. Is anyone cheerful? He is to sing praises. Now the first stanza of verse 13, it says, is anyone among you suffering? Then he must pray. The word suffering signifies to suffer hardship. Now, our situation now, we are really in what we call in a real hardship situations. And James looked at someone who is in physical and in spiritual trouble. They are suffering from something ailment and they are not in a good shape. However, James gave a solution to this ailment, and that is to pray. Prayer is the believer's great weapon in times of hardship. Nothing is more important during trial than prayer. We need to pray as individuals, and we need to pray in corporate prayer. Now, if we recall in book of Philippians chapter 4, verse 6, this is what Paul says. Be anxious for nothing, but in everything by what? By prayer and supplication. With thanksgiving, let your request be known to God through Christ Jesus. Now, we need to remember that the only antidote of hardship is what? Is prayer. According to Charles S. Brent, pray hardest when it is hardest to pray. Amen? Now, look at the second stanza of verse 13. Is anyone cheerful? He is to sing praises. Now, the word cheerful means to put in good spirit. A cheerful person is someone who has a healthy soul, or what we call a joyful attitude. He is a person with prosperity in his soul, not in material matters. Therefore, we call it he has or she has spiritual energy. Why? Because his heart, or her heart, is what we call healthy soul, a joyful soul. Hallelujah. Now, listen to Psalm chapter 5, verse 11. But let all those rejoice who put their trust in you. Let them ever shout for joy because you defend them. Let those also who love your name be joyful in you. Now, meaning, there is a time for prayer and to sing praises to God. Listen to the praise, but let all those rejoice. And then the second praise, let them ever shout for joy. Hallelujah. The last one, your name be joyful in you. See, the joy, joyful and rejoice. How many times? Three times, mga igsoon. Nga ang kasing-kasing, na puno sa kalipay sa Ginoo, it will express sa imong kaugalingon. Sa panimalay na mo, praise glory to God. Adlaw-adlaw dunay concert. Ano man? Akong sister wife mo kanta, ang akong mga anak manganta. Why is that? Because the Bible declares, out of the abundance of heart, the mouth speak. Unsay sud silang kasing-kasing, sa among kasing-kasing, it will come out what? It will express in singing to our living God. Let me give you an example of what happened in Book of Acts chapter 16. Now, while Paul and Silas was in prison, naani sila sa prisuhan, mga igsoon. But listen what happened inside in the prison cell. Now, listen. In 25, it says, but at midnight, Paul and Silas were praying and singing hymns to God, and the prisoners were listening to them. Now, ang sitwasyon sa pagkapriso, mga igsoon, wala mahimong babag sa ilang pagdaig o pagsimba sa Ginoo. So the circumstances in our life, dili kini mahimong babag na makadaig ta, makasimba. Just like what happened now. Na bisan pa na kining pandemic karon nga gitawag nato COVID-19, apan kining mga butanga, dili kini mahimong babag nang imong kasing-kasing makadaig ug makasimba ka sa Ginoo. Amen? The feeling of the Spirit of God in our life produce a song in our heart. The spiritual singing is an expression of what? Of a joyful heart. So makita nato, mga igsoon, og ang imong kasing-kasing puno og kalipay diya sa Ginoo, magsige lang kag daig sa Ginoo. Amen? Even though nga nataning taliwala sa gitawag natog pandemic, but friends, if your heart is full of joy, it will express sa pagsimba o paghimaya sa atong buhing Diyos. In verse 14 it says, is anyone among you sick? Let him call for the elders of the church and let them pray over him, anointing him with oil in the name of the Lord. Now, James is showing us how the church is to minister to the sick individual. The church must be concerned with the condition of the sick person's faith. That's where the elders of the church are to get involved. And the focus is not much on healing physically, but on the spiritual aspect of the sick person. And this is why James tells the sick to call for elders. Because why? Because sickness has deep spiritual implication all the time. And the elders are to be what? Are to be spiritual keepers of the flock. That's the reason why elders, they are supposed to be what? They are to be man of prayer. elders or leaders or pastor, and then listen to the praise, let them pray over him. What does James have in mind by this statement? Meaning, the elders are to what? Are to physically visit and touch the sick person, but not in this time because of what we call COVID-19. We are not allowed to visit. However, what we can do is to follow up them by phone or by messages. And it says, anointing him with oil. Here in this praise, the elders are what? Are acting as physicians of the soul, as in the sense that doctors of the body. And the common way during the early days to help promote healing of the wound was to rub oil on the surface, keeping the area soft. And this was their practice during the early church, based on Luke chapter 10 in the story of the Good Samaritan. Now, we'll go to the third one. Be a man of faith in verse 15 to verse 16. Listen to verse 16. Verse 15, I mean. And the prayer offered in faith will restore the one who is sick, and the Lord will raise him up. And if he has committed sin, they will be forgiven him. Now, listen to the praise. And the prayer offered in faith will restore the one who is sick. Now, we need to understand that God does not grant immediate healing for every prayer of faith. Now, if this thing will happen, so what do you think will happen in the world? Na every time nga mo, ampuha na to, ang dunay sakit, mayo di, wanay mamatay. That is what will happen. So wanay mga matay na to. But this body is designed to die. Mo'y program ini mga igsoon. This is not designed to be eternal, kini nga flesh. No. This body is designed to die. Now, if we recall, during the time of Paul, in 2 Corinthians chapter 12, verse 7, si Pablo, doon ay gitawag thorn of flesh. I mentioned this last time. And the Bible called it the messenger of Satan, a sickness allowed by God. And what happened? Paul pleaded 3 times to God. But here's what happened. Wa siya gitubag sa Ginoo. Ang gihimo sa Ginoo, God gave him a promise. And the Bible says, Paul, my grace is sufficient. Now, the best approach in praying for a sick person is to pray with humble heart before God and simply leave the matter to God. Why? Because God knows His business. Don't believe na moingon dan si pastor lang paampuan na to, kaya si pastor mo ampuan na, maayog yun na siya. No, it's not. A pastor is not a superman. But God is our great healer God. Amen? Now look at verse 16. The Bible says, therefore, confess your sins to one another and pray for one another so that you may be healed. The effective prayer of a righteous man can accomplish much. Now, James reminds us that mutual confession and prayer brings healing for what? Both physically and spiritually. And here's one thing. Confession can free us from unresolved sin. Listen to Psalm 66 verse 18. It says, "If I cherish sin in my heart, the Lord would not have listened." Si Binisaya pa, "Kung wala ko pa isulti ang akong sala, wala unta na mati ang Ginoo kanako." Nga sa ato pa, "Confession removes limitation to the work of the Holy Spirit into our life." Nga ugang atong kinabuhi ang imong kasing-kasing, dunay nagtago nga mga butang nga gitawag natong hidden wealth or hidden sin. In Book of Ephesians chapter 4 verse 30, the Bible says, "Do not grieve the Holy Spirit." So wala makalihok ang Ginoo, ang Espiritu diha sa imong kasing-kasing. Why? Because something nga imong gitagutaguan. According to Psalm 66 verse 18, "Nga ugwa pa nako gikumpisar sa Ginoo ang akong sa dili unta siya mamati sa akong pag-ampo." Another thing is that confession breaks the power of hidden sin. Now in John chapter 8 verse 36, this is what the Bible says, "If the Son will set you free, you will be free indeed." Now the moment you confess your sins to God, you can have what? Deliverance from the certain sin nga imong gitagutaguan sa imong kasing-kasing diha kang Kristo. Amen? Note the word "confess to one another" means to somebody who is spiritually matured in whom you can trust. Adto ka mo confide sa usa ka Kristohanon nga imong nakitaan nga spiritually matured nga ang sa nga imong i-confess ngadto niya dili mahimong gossip ngadto sa uban. We need to be very careful. Why? Because a reckless or unwise confession of sin can be what? Can be catastrophic. Or it will result more sin. I recall atong usa ka igsoon nga wa pa makristohanon. Sa wa pa kuno siya makristohanon, nagtinunto ang iyang bana. Onya dito siya siyang amiga sod nangayog advice nga maoning nahitabo. "Ang gitubag abini mo unsa? Bas lang imong bana paghimog pareho." Can you imagine that? Ang sa mubunga ug laing sa. And that's the reason why unwise or reckless confession of sin can be what? Catastrophic. Amen? So we need to be very careful. Asa ta mo adto? To those whom you can trust. Spiritually matured person. And then the Bible says, confess your sin to one another. Sa ato pa, dili ra ding one side. Dili ra ang usa mo sulti. Ug moari ka nako, ari ka mo. Mudol nako, pastor. Doon ako ikuan, pastor, kining doon ako struggle, mao na struggle nako. Of course, ang akong i-share niya, ug ikaw igsundo na struggle, we're the same. So, mu-acknowledge po ko sa akong weakness nga ito niya. Kaya nga naman, ingon dere, confess your sins to one another. It's not one-sided. One another. Why? Because I'm not a perfect father. I'm not a perfect pastor. I'm not a perfect husband. So, mag-sharing me sa among sitwasyon. Mauna ingon sa Biblia, we need to be what? We need to be wise. Amen? Why? Because the Bible says, the effective prayer of righteous man can be what? Can accomplish much. Now, It is very important for a church, for a church member to grow in righteousness. Kinahanglan mutubo ta diring dapita ang paglakaw nga dunay pagkamatarong. Why is that? Because righteousness adds power to our prayers. The lack of righteousness within the body of the believers causes our prayers to be weak. Wa ganita maglakaw sa pagkamatarong sa atong kinabuhi, huyang ang atong pag-ampo, gani bisag kasakisami dili makaabot. Why? Because the Bible declares God is holy and we need to walk with holiness. And the purpose of fellowship of the body of the believers is what? Is to support and pray for each other. And that's the reason why every Friday, 7 p.m., doon na tayo gitawag na virtual intercessory prayer meeting. So, gi-invite ta mo Friday 7 p.m. Doon na tayo virtual fellowship intercessory prayer meeting. Among i-post ang link alas 6 sa hapon and then makasulod mo pagkala city sa atong intercessory prayer meeting every Friday. And unsay purpose dito? To support each other and pray for each other. Amen? Hallelujah. Ngano man, because the Bible says, the prayer of a righteous man can accomplish much. Praise the Lord. But here's the thing. In 1 John chapter 3, verse 20, the Bible declares, God knows all things, meaning past, present, and future. Now, here in James chapter 5, verse 16, it says that our prayer can accomplish much. Here's a question. If God knows all things, is it possible for us to influence God through our prayers? Or how our prayer can accomplish much if God knows all things from eternity? Well, the simple answer is beyond our ability to understand. But the Bible tells us that God hears our prayer when we pray according to His will. Now, listen to 1 John chapter 5, verse 14, it says, this is the confidence which we have before Him, that if we ask anything according to His will, He hears us. Here's the question once again. What does it mean to pray according to God's will? Now, finding God's will depend on knowing the principle of God's word. And that is why the word of God commands us to pray in spirit and according to the spirit. How is that? How is it possible? Now listen to John chapter 6 verse 63. It says, flesh counts for nothing. My word is what? Is spirit and it is life. Meaning, the better we understand God's word, the better we will know what to pray for. Hallelujah. And the good thing is that God promises to grant the desire of our heart if we walk according to His word. Listen to Psalm chapter 37, verse 4. Delight yourself into the Lord, and He will give you the desire of your heart. So there is a contract. The contract is that delight yourself into the Lord, and He will give you the desire of your heart. Now, in the New Testament, it says, in book of Matthew chapter 6, verse 33, seek ye first the kingdom of God and His righteousness, and all of these things shall be added unto you. which is totally the same context in Book of Psalm chapter 37 verse 4. Seek first the kingdom of God. Delight yourself into the Lord, and He will give you the desire of your heart. Hallelujah! And in contrast, if we are not living according to His word, then don't expect something from God. Therefore, the issue is not if God answers our prayers, because God does answer prayers. However, here is the issue. The issue is about our abiding in God's will so that our prayers will be answered. Praise the Lord. It's about our abiding in Him. In John chapter 15, verse 7, this is what the Bible declares. If you abide in me and my word abides in you, then ask whatever you wish. It will be given unto you. The word abide means to stay or to remain. The Bible doesn't say, ask whatever you wish. It will be given to you. There's a word abide. Abide in me and my word abides in you. So it's a package dealing zone. If you abide in me. Now, ang pangutana diri, if I will ask you, nag-ampo ba ka? Did you pray? Yes, I pray. Now, here's the question again. Did you read the Word of God? No, I'm not reading the Word of God. Then you are not praying. Why? Listen once again. If you abide in me and my Word abide in you, then ask. So, duha ka butang ang na. Abide to Jesus Christ and in His Word. Then you can ask. You cannot just say that you are praying without reading the Word of God. Amen? Now, let's go to number 4. Be a man of prayer. In verse 17 to verse 18, it says, Elijah was a man with a nature like ours, and he prayed earnestly that it would not rain, and it did not rain on the earth for 3 years and 6 months. Now, Elijah was a man with a nature like ours. James now illustrates the power of prayer in the life of Elijah. God answered the prayers of man just like us. We don't need to be a super spiritual people for God to answer our prayer. God hears and answer our prayer in spite of our human weaknesses. Now, let me give you an example. Abraham is not perfect. Moses is not perfect. Daniel is not perfect. David is not perfect. Mary is not perfect. Saul or Paul is not perfect. There were people like us. Now, let me give you an example in Book of Acts chapter 14. In verse 8 to verse 15. The background is that Paul and Barnabas was preaching in the place called Lystra. And there's a crippled man since birth listening to Paul. And Paul commanded him to stand up. And you know what happened? He stand up and began walking. And what happened after that? Sa dihang ang tao ning lakaw, ning barog ug ning lakaw, ang mga tao nanyagit nga si Pablo ug si Barnabas Ginoo. They are shouting. They shout that God come down from heaven like man. So ang ilang pananaw kang Pablo, mga Diyos nga nanganaog si Pablo ug si Barnabas. But listen to verse 15. Listen here. Ingon ni Pablo, man, why are you doing these things? We also are men with the same nature as you. Listen. We also are men with the same nature as you. and preach to you that you should turn from this useless thing to the living God. Nga naman, they are worshiping idols. Gisimba na nila si Pablo o si Barnabas o gani in this case, gigisi ni Pablo ang iyang sinina. Iyang gigisi. Why? Because dili siya gusto magpa-worship during that time. And can you imagine, if during the time of Paul, dili siya magpa-worship, how much more this time? And that's the reason why, mga isoon, my challenge sa inyo, matag-usa nga nagpaminaw karon, I'm not convincing you na mubalhin mo og relihiyon. My challenge in your life right now is to read your Bible. Og muadto ka sa Facebook karon, daghang kay challenge. Doon ay challenge sa mga picture nga black and white. A lot of challenges happening now. But here's my one challenge. Please read your Bible. Unsa ingon ni Pablo diri? We are men with the same nature as you, and preach to you that you should turn from this useless thing. Listen, useless thing to the living God who made the heaven and earth, the sea, and all things that are in them. Friends, please accept my challenge. Read the Bible. Amen? Listen to verse 18. Then he prayed again, and the sky poured rain, and the earth produced its fruit. Now, this is the story of the prophet Elijah and prophet of Baal and Mount Carmel. Wherein, during this time, in 1 Kings chapter 18, in verse 2, Samaria experienced a severe famine. Grabe ang pait nila. Why one? 3.5 years. Imagine that. But if you read continuously in the 1 Kings chapter 18, from verse 42 to verse 45, you will find out that Elijah boldly prayed for rain because he strongly put his confidence in God's ability to answer to his prayers. And you know what happened, mga isoon? Indeed, Elijah's prayer, given in faith, were able to accomplish miraculous thing. Why? Because in verse 45 it says, then there was a great rain. Hallelujah. Friends, Elijah is the same. The same your life, my life. But there's one difference. With the word abiding, we need to abide in Jesus and in His Word. Listen to 1 John chapter 5 once again, verse 14. This is the confidence we have in approaching God, that if we ask anything according to His will, He hears us. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Now, the last one is in verse 19 to verse 20. Be a man of encouragement. Verse 19 says, brethren, if anyone among you wanders from the truth, and someone turns him back, that is quoted in New King James Version. But listen to the ESV. It says, my brethren, if any among you stray from the truth, and one who turns him back. Now, the word if and the word among you, it indicates the possibility of a fellow believer's wanders from the truth is likely to happen. Why? Because of the word if and the word among you. So what happened here, James extends a word of encouragement to a mature believers who bring fellow Christians back from the age of what we call spiritual defeat. The word wander means to go astray. And here's one thing. The wanderer is someone who neglects to follow the word of God and goes into a state of rebellion against God. And this believer wanders from what? From Christian truth. And the word turns him back. Someone who turns him back means to turn about or to turn towards. The idea is to turn from to a point or where the one has been before. Now, in my job, mga igsoon, sa nagtrabaho pa ko sa una, in my secular job, this is what happened. Sa barko man ko gikan. Ang akong barko nga gidala is the length is 230 meters and 32 meters breadth. So dako siya. Pero ang akong trabaho is different ining mga barko nga nanagan karon. Ang among trabaho is mag-install ining mga dagko nga mga platform sa tunga sa dagat. And what happened is that magtrabaho may og 10 meters ra, duol ra kayo. Now, makakita mo ng sinihan nga mga platform magkayo. Sa ato pa, nag-produce na og oil. So, anhami magtrabaho, duol ra kayo na siya. Now, ang akong barko, nga gitrabahoan mga ison, tagaan ra na ko siya og kay 10 meters naman ko. Tagaan ako sa limitation nga 1 meter through computer. Ang akong kuman, ini nga set point, mo drift gani kag 1 meter, mo balik yung kadya. So, ang set point na ko, mo to'y base yung kanuna siya. Mulihok ang barko dere, mo balik na siya dito, mulihok ang barko dito, mo balik na po siya. Now, in application to Christian life, ang idea dere, nga pabalikon kadtong nasalaag sa original set point niya. And here's the only thing. Our love to our fellow believers will drive us to risk of confronting the one who wanders from the truth. Kining ning backslide mga isoon, kining ning talikod sa Ginoo, critical kayong spirito ini. Very critical spirit. And you need to risk pag-confront ini mga tawhana. Without the love of God, dili ka kahimo ini. Muna, it needs the divine intervention of God. Listen to Book of Galatians chapter 6 verse 1. It says, brothers and sisters, if someone caught in sin, you who live by spirit should restore, listen to the word, shall restore that person gently. The word gently, meaning out of love. But watch yourself so that or you also may be tempted. Amen? Now, James suggests that if somebody wanders from the truth, any believers in right relationship to God could turn him back to fellowship with God. Maunay papil sa usa ka tinuray nga Kristohanon. Now, dunay ning likoy nga imong nailhan, what we need to do is what? Gently, out of love, we will confront that brother or sister na mobalik sa Ginoo. Why? Because in verse 20 it says, let him know that he who turns a sinner from the error of his way will save his soul from death and will cover a multitude of sin. Now, one sign of a healthy church is a church that take an active role in bringing back the lost sheep. If you recall Book of Matthew chapter 18, verse 12, this is what the Lord Jesus Christ says. What do you think? If someone had 100 sheep and one of them wandered off, wouldn't he leave the 99 on the hillside and go in search for the one that wandered off? Now, the business of restoration is to be the business of the church. When a member of a church wanders from the truth, we must go to them in love and in truth to bring them back. Hallelujah. Now, in conclusion, when a church member's wanders outside the safety zone of the body of Christ, they are opening themselves to the attack of the devil. And that is the very dangerous situation. And James tells us, if we go and speak to that person, and they repent and came back, their soul will be saved from death. And not only that, he also says that this reconciliation will cover many sin. Now listen here. James says, their soul will be saved from what? Death. What does it mean? Friends, we are not talking about salvation. We are talking about physical death. Why is that? Why? Because according to 1 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 30, this is why. Because of this, many of you are weak and sick, and quite a few have died. Why? This is the reason. Verse 27 of 1 Corinthians chapter 11. This is why those who eat bread and drink the cup of the Lord's inappropriately will be guilty of the Lord's body and blood. Now, according to Paul, some people died because during the Lord's Supper, they took the bread without examining their heart. And today, we will do a communion Sunday and first examine your heart. Examine your heart and pray to God. Ask forgiveness. And in the name of Jesus, there is a forgiveness of sins. Hallelujah. Let's call the praise and worship team to have one song in preparation for our communion.
For the prize you've paid.
1 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 23 says, "For I received from the Lord what I also delivered to you, that the Lord Jesus, on the night when he was betrayed, took bread." And when he gave thanks, he broke it and said, "This is my body, which is for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way, he also took the cup after supper and saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. For as often as you eat this bread and drink the cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until he comes. And whoever, therefore, eats the bread or drinks the cup of the Lord in an unworthy manner will be guilty concerning the body and the blood of the Lord. Let a person examine himself then, so to eat of the bread and drink the cup." Verse 29, "For anyone who eats the bread and drink without discerning the body eats and drink judgment on himself. And that is why many of you were weak and ill, and some have died." Now, what is the meaning of communion? And how do we prepare communion? Now, ang Biblia nagpasabot nga in verse 26, every time we drink the cup and eat the bread, we proclaim the Lord's death until he comes. And how do we prepare the communion Sunday? The Bible says in verse 27, we need to examine our heart. We need to ask forgiveness from the Lord. Otherwise, the Bible says, it is an unworthy manner. Meaning, kinahanglan ka, ikaw og ako, mga igpasaylo sa Ginoo before we will take what we call the wine and the bread. And then, on ang hinungdan, sa verse 13, undiri, that is why many of you, daghang kaninyong masakiton, ang uban namatay. Why? Because ato ning gihimo in an unworthy manner, which means before nato himuon, what we have to do, we have to ask forgiveness to God. Search our heart. And friends, mga igsoon, we will pause for a little while and pray, search our heart, ask forgiveness before the Lord. Let us pray. We will eat the bread and drink the wine. Hallelujah. Praise God. Lord, thank you, God. Salamat ginmo sa imong pagkamayo, God. We thank you, Lord. Nabisan pa man sa among pagkamasalaypon. Bisan pa man sa among mga sala nga nahimo, Ginoo. Apan imong gipadala ang imong bugtong anak sa cross sa Kalbaryo. Aron ang matag-usa nga mudawat kanimo to be a Lord and Savior of their life, mahimong imong mga anak. Nalaygon ka, O Diyos, ining adlawa, takos kang pasidunggan, takos kang pasalamatan, sa ngalan ni Jesus, kinapag-ampo. Amen o amen. Hallelujah! Happy Lord's Day! And God bless you all.
for our last song, church. Let us sing All I Have Is Christ.
All I have is Christ.
pagkatapos ng service, O God, Lord. Truly, O God, Lord, we carefully bring you back all the glory, all the highest praises and thanks. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Once again, church, happy Lord's Day and have a blessed day.